Hi, good morning everyone. Myself, Vimal Panchal from Technological Solution Department would like to present a business continuity plan for our company and its significance in today's world. So, let's have a quick overview of our company. We are ISO 27001 certified in 2017, which covers commonly used terms and definitions in the Information Security Management Systems, which stands for ISMS family of standards, and we are capable to manage the security of assets such as financial information, intellectual properties, employee details, or information entrusted by third parties. So our clients are from different industries like finance, banking, aviation, which are protected by our antivirus solutions, which provide end-to-end security for endpoints and servers as well. Our two directors and founders, Lina Thomas and Suresh Patel, have started AVLS as a system integrator, and now we are a solution provider. So obviously we are growing since 22 years. Apart from this, we also provide technical professional service and support for network and wireless penetration testing, vulnerability assessments, authentications, and risk analysis. Being a VMware premium partner, professional services for all types of virtualization, server application and storage, and cloud infrastructure solutions. We have a specialized team in for that, which provides a very good support. This is our corporate structure. Everyone is equally important, but I have mentioned here the key players who have earned the respectful designations with the contributions they have offered. Our two directors offers divergent directorship. Mr. Thomas take care about the technical part, and Mr. Patel looks after the sales and business. Our core strength is our technical solution department, which comprises of 90 plus engineers, which include the developer team, threat hunting team, malware analysis team, support team, implementation team, which gives the support to the clients and customers, which are led by the Mr. Bosco. He is the manager, IT manager. Next, we have 8 project manager responsible for leading, planning, executions, and completion of project in an efficient, timely manner, which is led by our project manager, Neha Patel, who is there in our office, who have contributed a lot in last 10 years. Next is the Vilas Shinde, who secures and maintains the internal network and keeping the system within the office up to date with latest security patches, updates, etc. Next is the Mr. Menon, has a good sales team who have performed well in the last decade, bringing a lot of business. Mr. Ivan is the customer relationship manager who looks after every project personally and suggests a good thing about each and everything. John Paul is the head of legal department. His team looks after the legal matters, consultation and advices, etc. So, what is business continuity plan? BCP demonstrates how effectively a company plans to survive unexpected crises, disturbances, disastrous events, shifts, ensuring that vital business processes continue to work with reasonable limitations under most adverse circumstances. So let's talk about the benefits of business continuity plan. The very first point is the potential to save lives. I am not talking about the life of our company. It's about the lives of our employees. If you don't have the people, you can't recover at all. It is also a good way to show you care about the people you employ. Second is the builds confidence. Customer gains confidence once they are aware about the company they are dealing with, which is transparent about their ongoing business continuity efforts. Also, internally, the employees who are related to the business continuity plan gains confidence too. Third is the asset management. Fourth is the mitigation of any form of risk. Among the benefits of BCP The mitigation of not only the business risk is involved, but also the financial risk by creating a more resilient network or putting the right backup processes and procedures in place. You are reducing or lessening the risk of data breach, for example, or a substantial power loss, or any kind of cyber attack or system failures. The financial losses associated with such events, even the minor ones, can be avoided with a good BCP plan in place. Final point is the compliance. If you have adopted a set of business continuity standards, you can rest assured that the business is compliant with the industry mandates. Even if you don't have the regulations to adhere to, the compliance with standards provides proof to stakeholders that you are running a business responsibly. So all these benefits result into a resilient corporate culture, which is a very positive point about any company. As we all know about the pandemic, the coronavirus, which made every one of us to adopt the work from home concept, here the risk is the data protection and its privacy. The recent study shows that the 46% of small and medium enterprises have shared confidential files over mail during the lockdown, which is very risky because everyone is using their own local service provider's internet, which is a non-compliant according to the company standard. So we have to make necessary changes, and our main approach should be privacy and its protection by defining the policies. The very first point we can do is increase the bandwidth of VPN connection for smooth operations. Second, add two-factor authorization with better encryption. And lastly, spread the security awareness idea to all the employees through webinars to avoid cyber attacks. So these are the four points which are involved in BCP process. The first is project scope and planning. Second is business impact assessment. Third is the business continuity planning. And lastly, the BCP documentation. The very first is the project scope and planning. As with any formalized business process, the development of a strong business continuity plan requires the use of proven methodology. Our main aim is to secure the customers' organizations from any form of cyber threats, which is more critical than any other risk. Secondly, the BCP team selections. The members from each department should be appointed to form a BCP team with a team leader who can communicate directly with the directors. The resource requirement. The main resource required are the employees and some of the hardware and software requirements during the maintenance phases. Like the benefits. Here, the seat of the pant approach proves to be more costly because at times some disasters are not expected and cannot be handled with that approach. Hence, business continuity plan should be here. What is BIA and how it differs from BCP? BIA defines the critical processes which needs to be restored during the disruptive event, and BIA is the core part of BCP. Technically, it states that the assets that are critical to the continued sustainability and success of an organization and the threat posed to those resources. And the image below, we can see that the disruptive event occurred. The recovery time is kept less than the maximum tolerable downtime, which is the best practical method to resume the normal operations after testing and verifying the systems. So the important factors of business impact assessments are listed below. The qualitative and quantitative decision-making approach, along with identifying the priorities, includes the non-interruptive services and support to the clients. BCP team should assign the asset value in monetary terms, prioritizing the task on the basis of criticality of time and day-to-day essential operations when disaster strikes, like continuation of a malware analysis. Threat hunting team should be involved 24/7 to identify the zero-day attacks and include them in the daily signatures and roll out to the customers. Second is the risk assessment and impact analysis. So we have mentioned here the high impact examples, which are categorized in natural calamities, accidental, man-made, and project management. And last is the resource prioritization. It must be depending upon the impact, and proper SOP should be documented much in advance. So here are the possible risks, and management of that risk and mitigation plans according to that in our organization. First is any form of cyber attack like ransomware. If happens, isolate or segment the network to avoid the spread further. Verify the antivirus signatures on the rest of the machines. If not updated, update it. Involve threat hunting team for critical analysis, and the signature should be distributed through policy to all machines. Second, disaster because of third-party service, just like cloud vendors which your business rely on. Like the applications, like our applications which are hosted on the cloud vendors, in case if the disaster is caused at their side, then we should verify the contract with vendors and check the service level agreements and reach out to them for immediately restoring the operations. Now, third point is disaster risk data center caused by any natural or accidental reasons. Now, this point is we are all aware about, like each and every company is having a DR site. DR, just deploying the DR site at another location is not just enough. You have to maintain it. You have to do the regular maintenance check. Patching activity should be performed regularly. And lastly, the man-made risk, which consists of poor management skills and personal shortfalls. We need to bridge the skill gap and provide essential trainings, making right hiring decisions, giving clear behavioral feedback, defining the project scope, time, and budget prior to start of any projects, and all of this should be documented properly. Now comes the third phase of business continuity plan, which is continuity planning. And the very first point is strategy development. The strategy development links the business continuity plan and business impact assessment. All possible decisions made with qualitative and quantitative analysis should be considered and documented. Provisions and processes to be made to address all the risks with zero or minimum downtime. Goal is to ensure that the RTO, which is recovery time, should be less than overall maximum tolerable downtime so that the operations can resume as soon as possible. Depending upon the maximum tolerable downtime, the risk strategies can be classified as, first point, the risk can either be avoided with an alternative plan or accepted as expected, mitigated by setting the countermeasures, or else they can be transferred by outsourcing it to partner or vendors. Now let's come to the second point of continuity planning, which is provisions and processes for customer service. This is actually useful. We suggest you to create the knowledge base portal where each technical issue should be properly documented so that every time when the customer faces any technical issues, they should go through this portal and find the solutions quickly rather than raising the case tickets, which consumes time. Usually employees need quick solutions. So if everything is documented and updated over knowledge base portal with suitable keywords, customer can find the solution themselves, which will contribute to the reduction of new tickets, and the customer get what they want when they want with no human interactions. One more way, which is optional, is to set up the live chatbot setup system, which requires artificial intelligence, which proves somewhat beneficial because of quick response and all-time availability. So now these are the common important points which needs to be considered, like people, the most valuable asset, as we have discussed it earlier. Second, data, which requires timely backup with proper encryption. And second is the alternate facilities, like if the lightning strikes, which destroys the building automation system, you will need to find an alternate means to manage the heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. If the power outage is risk to the operation, then the generator can address the need for the critical functions. If the fire can affect office space, temporary rescue locations should be provided nearby. Once the analysis and risk associated with it is documented, the overall BCP plan should be presented to the top management for approval. Once the plan is approved, the training and education of the employees is important, which can create a sufficient awareness to reduce the risk. At last, the documentation. Everything should be documented, each and everything, which helps to maintain the track of each and every processes in the BCP. Lastly, the internal and BCP audit. Objectives is consult and hire the BCP expert who has the strong skills for company's overall improvement. Review overall project management. Review all BCP and DR plans. Scheduling the health check of security solutions and making reports by suggesting the action plans if anything is missing. And finally, the final audit report is vital as it decides the next activities involved in the improvement in overall BCP with director's approval. This way, BCP plays a very important role for any organization to face any unwanted disastrous events. So these are the references which were informational for the project. Thank you for your kind attention. Thank you.